About ready for camping, about ready to kill my shoulders. Look at this thing. Gonna have to figure out how to lighten stuff a bit, I think. Because I'm carrying a lot of stuff and the bag's completely full. But it's my second camping trip. I lost the footage when I filmed the first one. So for the purposes of filming, it's my first camping trip, I guess.
Dark ahead, some legs.
Hello, so I've come camping out the Oakhampton side of Dartmoor. I'm gonna go camping for a night with my mum and her friend. And she's got a dog there, a little setter dog. And I was hoping to walk up to High Wilhays, but the packs are quite heavy, so we'll see how far we get. We might just go up to West Milltor. Bye, doggy.
Just get me at my best angle.
Yeah, I know, I'm just going to film your camera.
That's
Joy's GoPro.
To get you going.
Here's Ezra, doggy. We are going up there, past the sign. See how long our shoulders last. Hi, Mum.
Yes.
Yes.
Hello. Oh, that's fine. Oh, no. I don't think I'm going to make it.
People up on West Mill.
There's only one good thing about this.
What's that?
Anything, any good to go up? Downhill in the morning.
It's downhill in the morning, yeah. The sunshine's starting to come out. Nice. Oh, all of that with the different stacks on it, yeah. There's East Mill Tor there, very windy. Steepton Tor. Not sure what the tiny one is actually. But foreground middle, Oak Tor. Oh, hold on, that's called Natterborough. Stands out more today. At the back is Cosden Beacon. There's the Northern Range. Ending of that wind farm, near the wind farm is, or in front of the wind farm I should say, Scary Tor and Tor's End. I'm weirdly doing okay carrying this bunch of stuff. This solar powered light I nabbed from the garden, that's what that is. Don't have to do anything, just leave it in the sun and then at night time just stick it to the roof of the tent. Yeah, I'm getting used to carrying this at the moment. It's not so bad. It's not a bad day though. It's kind of dry and bright and sort of cool breeze. Don't think I'd be able to do it on a day like the one where I went to Tavy Cleeve or Girt, or that feature over there is the Kirtery Clitters, which I don't know if it's meant to be a tour, but it doesn't seem like a tour to me.
Dartmoor
air. Doggy. Hey, doggy. Hey, doggy. I think we're gonna try for Yes Tor and High Wilhays after all.
What?
Sorry, I was talking to the camera, to be honest.
It's not
talking
to
you,
Joy.
Might visit that way down tomorrow morning, maybe. Gonna be crossing the brook soon. Yes Tor up there. We're gonna Redavenbrook, Zach.
Well,
Here's some water. Alright, Ezra.
If we can.
Ezra's going to wrap me up in his lead.
If you're in luck, you'll find that I can't get a signal on here. Ezra, come here.
Red of Enbrook.
Then what's it? Telegraph things?
Or... Yeah.
Those metal ones.
Pylons, right?
Pylons.
Yeah.
We'll put our tent well away from you.
No, I want you close
to me. I'll put it next to Tom.
He's my security.
Almost made it up to the rock stack of Yes Tor. I think we're going to set up around there today. Second highest place in Dartmoor. I think we're settling there because it's more sheltered with the rocks than High Will Hayes is. Found this little area around the back of Yes Tor. You can sort of see where we are. There's a trig point up there. Yeah, this is the area with the most flat bits that we found so far. Apart from over there, there's a kind of military hut, but there's not enough flat room around it, I think, for three tents, so this is the best bit. There's a cairn there. I might go there. Or to go in the wind with hardly any shelter but with amazing views. There's actually a bog here. There's a boggy bit. So yeah, I could go here. Or if I go up here. And there is a semi-flat bit just here. I mean, it's not flat, but it's flat enough for what you need, I think. So, the thing is, I'm in the wind, and I don't think this is that much shelter. So, I might end up going for the lower one. But the view up here is just like this impressive sight. Take two in hopefully a less windy place. There's Joy and our doggy. It was a bit of hard work when I was over there. And, well, over there, the wind wanted to take my tent from me really bad. It was pushing from my tent in, so it actually broke me. I don't know if I have an aerodynamic design of tent. is like rock just under the grass. But here's the campsite. Second highest point in South England, because the first is over there. High Well Hayes. You can sort of see the cairn on the left. Yeah, so this is our campsite for now. And I think Joy and Mum are around the corner. We've got a beautiful view. Initial two spots here. It would have been an amazing view to look out my tent window to up here. You can see even more in this direction, including Oakhampton Common. And the wind farm is lit up in the sun once again. Wow, look over there. So let's take a run over there, have a look at everything from high up. So here's our pillbox bit. We scouted this, just didn't think there was enough room for the tents. Maybe there was in hindsight, not sure. Here we are at the trig point and the flagpole. Last time I was up here, of course, with Dad. There were flying ants just everywhere. Look at that glowing tor over there, that's amazing. Sneaky-ass sheep trying to get close to our tents. Hey, what you doing? So it's 7:44. I've unpacked everything in my tent at last. Got the inflatable mattress there. Got my bag. I actually found out I just lost a Coke. I bought a little bottle of Coke and took it out the fridge this morning, put it in my bag. Had to secure it in a side strap. It's obviously come out somewhere while we were walking, because it's not here. And No one saw anything dropped. Damn it, where's my Coke? Pillow. Thin sleeping bag, which wasn't very warm last time. So I have brought clothes and I've brought a big blanket there, soft blanket. Got clothes. These are all the bags that my sleeping bags and stuff came in. Big towel. I actually just washed my hands with a tiny bar of soap and some water because there's various poop around where I put the tent pegs in. Camping bag there. I've got a spare battery for this camera that I'm using right now. That's a solar powered light. Phone, tissues, everything. Toiletries in bags there. I got I've got my phone here. While I was on Gibbet Hill camping, which is the first camp which I didn't get to bring in the footage of, this connected to the internet out on the hill, out on the tour. I was like watching frigging Twitch streams in the tent. I was like, how the fuck? I must have had really good data or something. I was not expecting to get any kind of internet while in a tent. I don't know what the hell happened. Toothbrush. I actually put toothpaste in a little plastic pot rather than take the whole toothpaste. Not that it cut down on weight. There's a bag of popcorn there. There's some custard creams. That's a water, which was actually a block of ice because I put the whole bottle of water in the freezer for a few days. There's some string there, which has actually been quite handy recently. Should probably take that all the time. What have we got here? Flannel, kitchen roll. I think Joy's brought a spade or a shovel for in case we need to go to the toilet out here. I didn't think of that. Yeah, so that's all my stuff off my back and spread out in the tent at last. And there's a cooking pots here and an igniter out there. Forgot to bring a sheet to put in that section of the tent. That could have been useful. Mum's got a cooking stove out there and she's done some kind of fajita pasta thing. I think we're going to have a go at cooking and eating that later. I'm not sure how that's going to work out, but we'll see. They've gone all off to walk to High Wilhays, I think. Maybe I'll go up there walking and cross them by in a minute. I'm not sure. I think it's going to be sunset at 9 o'clock. So what is it? 7:47, nearly 8 now. Got an hour till the sun sets. Wonder if we're going to get a real sunset over there. I think that's west. Is it west though? I don't know. I thought that was Plymouth actually. Maybe that isn't Plymouth. Getting windier and colder now. Mum and Joy seem to be coming back from the tour, so maybe I'll go over and cross their path now. If I go down this track slightly, I'll see it all the time. Where is the base of the track? Is this it over here? Oh yeah, this is it over here. No sign of any little red glints. I can't believe I lost that. I bought it, goddammit. Someone else is gonna find it before me. I'll just walk all the way down the track to Westmill Tor. I'll find my Coke and then I can come back up again. This is Tom's Coke adventure. No, I'm not going to do that. I'm going to go up to High Wilhays over there. And I'll just have to deal with water. I can tell I'm a little bit lift. There's a lot of fucking water here. I thought this would have dried up, goddammit. It's been a warm day. Still got about an hour till sunset. The tours over there are receiving some kind of mild light, even though we're kind of eclipsing the sun from them. It's kind of an orangey light over them. That's the Sowerton Tours in Branscombe's life. Looking a bit holy or something. I could call this a number zero stack. Didn't notice this last time. Ugh, pillow mound of lava. Well, I didn't say last time I made the previous High Well Haze video was that this stack up ahead, I think it's actually the second stack over there. I called it the second stack of High Well Haze, and apparently it's not. It's called Hamster Tor. Not hamster like the little pet rodent, but Hampster with a P. Maybe there's a guy called Mr. Hamster that was named after. There it is. See that cairn poking out? I think someone's made it bigger than it was last time. Second stack or hamster. Campsite's over there. So here's the next mound, where there's a little settlement thing on the ground next to it. Wow. See, here's the flat bit I thought was a settlement or something. And now I'm going to go over to the top of High Well Haze, where that cairn was I saw on the horizon. Highest point in southern England under the Brecon Beacons. Approaching now. That's a juicy view of Great Lengths Tor there. Look at that. Look at those curves, man. Here we are again on the granite brick road. Looks like a path, but yeah, doesn't it? Looks like there used to be a path between all these points. Places of paths. There have definitely been some visitors to Olympus last year. Highly cared. Doesn't stand out as much as Yestor does, even though there's like 2 meters height difference, I think, that makes this the tallest. Got all these here, some sort of ridges over here. Thank you. God, the sun's coming out, that's awesome. First field, brining up. This, that's currently the highest point in southern England, that's pretty cool. See stack 7 and a Fordsland ledge down there underneath Great Links. Places to camp here, but I bet it's windy as heck to try and keep a tent up. Be like me trying to do it earlier with the front buckling in. That stacks here, though. I think we've got dinger tor and lint tor down here. I believe this one's dinger tor, maybe. And then if we can see it, I don't know if we can probably see it, but is that it? Lint tor maybe? There's a strange wilderness over here on the way to Curtry Clitters and Oakmont Hill. Always loved this angle. Look at this submarine here. I've seen it again. Yeah, there were flying ants on this one as well before, I think. Beehive! I could get on top of this today. Haven't been on top of this. Forward momentum! Fuck. Yeah, no, there's no another one. There's Fordsland, that's the next thing. Okay, time to head back. When I can round these sheep, I might go and see if I can see black at all. I'm not going to go right to it, of course. I don't feel like I have time at the moment to walk all that way before the sun sets. No. There's a bit of bogginess around here. Unexpected. Look at this. This is cool. Look at this. I'm a fire starter. Freaking instigator. Yeah, if I do a big wide curve back to base camp over here. Oh, I'm starting to see Blacktor now actually. Yeah, there it is. Still have not visited this one. Blacktor, or Blacktor 2. There's old Hamster there again. Let's go over to his left. I can't remember if he's on top of this number one stack. Hey, this is where that track leads, didn't realise. Look at that, the northern range is catching the sunlight very nicely over there. You got some sunshine. Are you cooking? Hope you didn't trip over my guy ropes. How long has it only just started going on?
Yeah, but this won't take long to heat up.
Are you sure?
All it's got to do is heat up.
All right.
It hasn't really got a cook, it's only
TVP. There's the room inside a purple pop-up tent. They're quite nice, they go up way quicker than mine. I reckon it's got hot. Have you given it a taste test?
It's starting to bubble.
So starting?
Yeah.
Oh, well, bubbling's hot. I can see a little bit of I thought I saw steam. It's a little bit of steam. Does it beep every time you take a picture?
No, it's to go on.
Oh, right, on and off.
It's Val doing her one pot wrap. It's amazing.
It's amazing. I would have to come back.
Oh, we've got a nice little circle here. Right. If only there was a stone for Mum to sit on
right
now.
It's amazing, you see. Amazing.
Here we are. This is an amazing organic tortilla wraps.
And it's got, what's it got in it?
Nice, bubbly, steamy.
Some vegan mints. Is it vegan? Yeah, vegan mints.
Vegetarian at least.
What's in the green pot? Guacamole? What is that?
What?
Oh, lettuce. Oh. She's got lettuce.
Lettuce.
She's got salsa.
Salsa.
Cheese. Anything
That's
else?
What's going on it.
All right.
Isn't that enough?
That's enough.
This is your meal. Now, I'm going to sort of mock up one, and then Tom can have the first one.
That's a good idea.
Because he hasn't
Well, I think
eaten.
We've got two each. There's six. So, there's six wraps.
What about Ezra?
Can you divide it by six, Mum?
This goes.
What about Ezzy?
That's enough.
That's all you're getting.
Yeah, no.
Two.
Ezra,
I'm just saying, you've got to spread it out, right?
And he's not getting any.
But he can share.
We need some doggle biscuits.
Doggle
biscuits.
What?
Hey? Oh, it's your blooming thing.
It's his Joyce camera.
Some of this lettuce.
Some lettuce.
How much?
I have lettuce in my burritos.
Ezra's back.
But I have real beef. Cheese. Oh, I don't need the salsa.
You don't want the salsa?
I don't need the salsa. That's
Is that enough cheese?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
You need a little, only a little bit in each one.
Right. You're up next, Joy. One moment.
Shall I film? This is what I got.
Tom's
verdict. It's a mum homemade burrito.
Let's see if Tom approves. He's our guinea pig.
It's a bit like spaghetti bolognese, the sauce is.
Yeah, sort of.
Let's get some lettuce.
Yeah.
But you haven't died yet.
I might have put some
So is that a good sign?
Is it an okay lettuce, for camping?
Yeah, it's good. There's a little bit of spice. The lettuce gives the crunch. You need the lettuce for the crunch.
Good. Okay.
Pretty good. I haven't been poisoned.
Soon to have mine, so I will have to switch off.
Am I the poison guinea pig?
More spice.
Eating a burrito at a very high tour. We are getting a bit of sunset red. There it is. It's actually poking through. Very kind of dark and dusky around here now. Alright, yeah, I saw you do it. Oh, I missed the last sliver of sun because I was preparing the food and I missed the last sliver of sun. Well, I filmed a bit of it anyway.
Doesn't mean we have to come up here again next week.
No. We'll go to a different place next time. Missed the sliver of sun. Well, I filmed most of it. Been pretty good so far. Solar powered light ain't working though. Not enough for sunlight in the day.
Tom?
Yeah?
You're just going up the hill to see Oakhampton at night.
Yeah, I might come in a sec. Should have brought a brush, really. Or a hat. A beanie. I should bring a beanie next time. Okay. Get up, tent. Must remember not to trip over that. Oh, look at that. We're in the clouds. And a star, or a planet. Wind's picking up a bit. Some city lights are happening. It's becoming dusk now. Fingers are going a little bit numb. Cool. Pockets here and there. Yeah, Oakhampton's over Rotor, should I say. You probably can't even hear me. There's wind drifting through, clouds drifting through quite close to us. Getting dark. I did get turned around.
here soon. Oh, it's foggy and misty over there. It's probably rain and clouds touching the hill. I forgot we're touching the clouds up here.
Oh,
you can see all the atmosphere is drifting through.
Yeah.
We're going to be in a cloud in a minute.
In a minute.
Yeah, best get indoors.
That's a shame you're not facing in towards us a little bit.
Well, we had a big kerfuffle, didn't we, trying to put that up. Oh, you can sing.
You might be singing.
I'll hear you from my tent. Come on, Zippy. Come on, Zippy. Ooh. Come on. Come on, Zip. Come on, Zip. Okay. Okay. Okay.
What's it all about?
Yikes!
Can you hear that in there, Tom?
Yes!
Yay.
What is that?
Wait.
Okay. So I think that's a karaoke microphone. I think that's what that's meant to be. Is this how you're communicating?
Yeah.
Okay. Let's see how the night goes on Yestor. I'm wondering if the wind's going to pick up my tent and me and or one of us sling us off the hill. Is the result of the rain that's been on and off around the night, and it's oh, the moment.
Oh, good morning! Yay! Thank God!
Just get up here. No insects the whole time, except this fella who's trying to sneak in. Right, finally packed away most of the indoor stuff in there. So now it should only be the tent to pack away when I want to, but as you can see everything's really wet still. Ground's wet, tent's wet. Hello! 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 It's like a whole different world this morning. Completely foggy. I was hoping it was going to clear, but I don't think it's going to. I just hope we don't encounter rain while we're packing up the tents or walking back. Peppa's joined us.
Good morning, you've missed breakfast.
Peppa came and brought us cakes. Might be all the blue sky we're gonna get. I don't know if it's gonna clear up more than this. Thank you.
all loaded and heading back down right now. Can't pull back because this camera is attached to my rucksack. We've actually got sunshine, lass. After all that fog, we finally got our clear sunshine. Oh, let's tote these heavy packs back to the car. Goodbye, Yestor. We have camped on you. We can now actually see you in the sunshine. God, if only it was like that for most of the morning. And now we are heading down. Nice and clear. You found the coke, didn't you? She found it by the river crossing of Red of Enbrook.